Hey everyone, welcome back. Today in this video we are going to be going through section A, problem 3. If you don't yet have yourself this mock test, head over to the link in the description. So let's get straight into it. Part A, build this part in SolidWorks, use the values below as needed, then find the mass of the parts in grams. Okay, so we have everything that we need to. Hint, this part can be built using only three features. Okay, so let's get straight into it. Switching over to SolidWorks. I'm gonna again start with our basic shape and dimension it later. So we'll start off with a circle on the one side. We know that we have one larger circle and one smaller circle. And on this side we have a tiny circle in the middle of that and a circle on that side. Between the two of them we have straight lines that are tangent to the circle on both sides. So we set those two to tangent and then we can trim away the parts we don't need. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Let's head back over to our PDF and check our dimensions. So center to center distance is 38. Our inner circle diameter here is 20, and add a 6 millimeter radius to the outside of that and we'll get our outer. And here we'll do the same thing. So that's 6 and 6, that's 6, and that's 20. Okay, so let's head back over to SolidWorks and put all those values in. So we said that our center to center distance is 38. Our inner diameter here is 20. The distance between these two is 6 millimeters. This one, the diameter is 6 again. And the distance between these two is going to be 6 as well. Okay, so we can confirm that sketch, head back over to the PDF, and we'll need to extrude it to a thickness of 6 millimeters. Okay, heading back over to SolidWorks, we can hit extrude, enter our value of 6 millimeters, and confirm that. Okay, next step, we need to add in our step for the large circle. So we have that, we can coincident that or make them co-radial there, and we can convert the entities like so. Then we need to check our dimension for extrusion. So that's 6 millimeters minus 14, which gives us a height of 8. So let's head back over to SolidWorks and add that in. Hit extrude. Have the correct direction. 8 millimeters and confirm. Lastly, for the model, we have the little segment down the bottom, so we'll start on that face. We will make these, not the face, the edge, we'll make them co-radial, and since no other information is given, I'm assuming that this hole goes all the way through, so we'll convert the entities for that. Confirm. Let's head back over to our PDF and check the height of that. So that'll be extruded to 24 millimeters. Back to SolidWorks. Extrude to 24 millimeters. Confirm. Okay, lastly, to add in our material. So according to our question, our material is going to be galvanized steel with a density of 7870. So let's head back over and do that now. Material galvanized steel 7870. We can go ahead and apply that. What happened? Huh. Okay. That looks a bit better. And finally, to check our mass. So we head over to evaluate mass properties. We get a mass of 128.03 grams. So let's confirm our answer. 128.03 grams. Awesome. Did you guys have any issues with that? If you did, let me know in the comments. If you have any questions or feedback or recommendations or requests, let me know in the comments. And if this video helped you at all, give me a like. And hopefully I will see you guys in the next video.